Studio 54. People want to hear about that night. You got turned away.
So what happened was, so what Pete's referring to is that, so our music is pumping inside, right? So everybody inside is dancing all of our songs. And the thing that was cool about Studio 54 is that obviously they had to appeal to the pop crowd, what they used to call the I know I'm in Europe, but they used to call it the Euro trash crowd or the bridge and tunnel
crowd. Name it.
That's what they used to say. So they wanted to hear all of the pop current stuff, but they also liked underground music too. They wanted to hear the next gen of what was going to rock the dance floor. So our record, Everybody Dance, was actually more popular than Dance Dance Dance. So Grace Jones heard Everybody Dance and said, I want those guys to produce me. So she got in touch with us, and she says, okay, darling, this is what you do. I sound terrible doing Grace, but she sort of sounds like Marlene and Dietrich or something, like Marlene and Dietrich from Jamaica. So she says, all right, Nile, darling, this is what you do. Is you tell them you're personal friends of Grace, and just say that that's it. You're personal friends of Grace Jones, and they'll let you in. So we go to the stage door, which is what she instructs us to do. We knock on the door and say, we don't say, the personal friends of Grace. But we say, yo, man, you know, we're Chic. We're personal friends of Grace Jones. And the guy looks at us. I mean, he wanted to laugh, but he slams the door on our faces and says, fuck off. And we're like, we're banging on the door. No, it's a true story. She told us, she said exactly this. So we're thinking that this is like rock and roll code. Personal friends of Grace. So we're trying to get it right. Yo, we're personal friends, they're personal friends, I'm a personal friend. We're personal friends of Grace. We're personal friends of Grace. Naya, tell them you're personal friend. You're personal friends of Grace. Fuck off. So we went around the corner to my apartment, which was on 52nd Street. The back door of Studio 54 is on 53rd Street. And so, man, my guitar sounds sucky today. Oh, there we go. So, music, we play music for fun. I don't know how many people in this room are musicians, and I consider DJs musicians. You don't have to play an instrument in today's world because the technology has moved it to the place where it's just about being creative and expressive. So the way I express myself is on this thing. This is just my tool. So we play music for fun, just like when we were early, you know, DJ. You play music for fun. You're having a good time. You're sitting there doing your shit, cutting it up. And so we went to my house and we started going. This is the true story. We went there and started going. And we got into it. You should have seen, if you were a fly on the wall, Bernard and I, we were doing choreography and we were like, fuck off. And we were like, all funky and grooving, and we wrote a bridge, and I mean, we were really, really into it. We were laughing and joking, and then Bernard finally said in that way that only Bernard Edwards can say, you know this shit is happening, right? And I looked